Que pare. Oh, my mic's over here. Now I'm live. Now I have to commit. I have to stay live for 62 hours and 45 minutes. It's the mandatory amount of time. There we go. My new video is tanking. Shut up, me in the past. Oh my god, I'm not signed into this thing. Hello, people. People, please watch my new video if you're above 18 because it's age restricted, which means it's going to go from doing well to not well. Okay, let me pin this. We got to boost it up. We got to save my video. All right. Anyways, there's the video. It's a great video, in fact. One of the best. One of the top ones I've done today. It's the only video I posted today. I am in physical pain. I am. It's true. Not because of like being stabbed or anything cool. Well, I just because of my tattoo. My tattoo has been hurting. And every time I try to work out at the moment, which I've been doing, it's been a constant battle of lifting my arms up and the tattoo being stretched and hurting. As you can see, it's still red. Still red. So what can I do about that, you know? What can I do? Lagging? No, I can't. The pick is quiet. Echoing. I shouldn't be echoing. No, I'm not echoing. You're just a troll. There's no echo. Thank you, Lindsay. The driving video is great, and it sucks that it's going to flop. But it's not going to stop me from doing another drunk video, I promise you. In fact, I have another one I want to do, and it's me using my plane controller and flying a plane drunk. Because obviously I've mastered driving drunk, so I should fly drunk. How did you like Jordan Sweetle's birthday? I wished him happy birthday, and that's as far as that conversation went. Well, he said he might come to LA at one point, so therefore, the audio is repeating. Are you fucking kidding me? My fucking shoe just cut my fucking chair. Why is it doing this? I gotta reopen this. Oh wait, I have a bunch of things open. Maybe I'm playing it. What? Hello? Are you kidding me? My fucking stupid mic is echoing. Fuck. I just have it open on stream. It's not anymore. Thank you, Riley. Thank you, Caro. Caro Gallagher. Like Shameless. Thank you for the thingy, Abby. Welcome back, Andy Biersack. Hey, it's me, Andy Biersack. Let's talk about things in circles. He does talk. He'll talk about something for 10 minutes, but never get to what he's talking about. And I love that about him. Anyways. What I need is a bad bit. No, I'm cheating. I don't. I mean, my hair looks dumb, bro. Do I do this? No. Then I look like an idiot. No matter what, I look like an idiot. Johnny, are you in your flop air? I don't give a fuck. Yes, I'm in my flop air. Fucking let me flop. I don't give a fuck. I don't need to be relevant. It's done. We had our time. Should I do juggalo makeup? What time is it for you? Yes. You drove so well. Someone should give you an Evo. I don't know. The Evo C. What the fuck is that? Oh, it's a cart. It's like a emergency driving cart. Okay. Thank you for writing that out. It's an EVDC. Or no, it looks like an E. I don't know. Emergency driving cart. No. Put your hair in pigtails. No. Why would I do that? I mean, I would, but why? What is my incentive at the moment? I haven't filmed the Q&A video. I have so many other videos to film. I haven't gone there. We'll see if we do it. I don't know. What's up, Vic? Dye your hair? Ooh. Johnny, you have nice nostrils? Oh, thanks. I was thinking that maybe I need to trim my nostril hair or something. It's just something I like to do. It's not even like a problem. It's just something that I like to maintain. I think I'm mentally like a little bananas. Ooh. Look at this bendy ass lighter, dude. This is like bendy lighter. You can like... Oh, it doesn't work like that? So you have to have it... Huh. Can you bend it while it's like flaming? Oh yeah, you can. So you can kind of control fire. A video should be a day in the life of you. It's mostly 90% of my life I sit here. 90% of the life I live. The rest of my life I don't sit here, but 90% of it I sit here. So it's a mixed bag. Don't light yourself on fire. Don't tell me what to do. You're making me want to fucking do it. New video was funny. Thank you. I hope it does okay. I hope so. You should do a paintball fight with Jake. Like film that or something. I don't know. That'd be fun, I guess. I'm not drunk. I feel like you're projecting. You're drunk. The skunk. I haven't seen the skunk, no. I forgot about that thing. You and Jake need to go camping. I don't know if we're going to do that, because we did that, and we're going to have to give that time before we refilm that. I feel like people are just telling me things to do. Do this. Imagine being like a person just existing in life and people just telling you things to do constantly. It's so weird. Are you a cat or a dog person? I fucking like both, but I feel like dogs, I can lay on dogs, like my head and stuff, so that's kind of cool. But dogs got a lot of energy. Cats don't have very much energy usually, so I feel like there's a chance. I enjoy both. I don't know. If I wasn't allergic to cats, I would really enjoy that, I guess. But I'm allergic, so it makes them not as exciting to be around, because I can't really embrace the existence of a cat. I can't really like pet cats or anything. Sounds like a very weird way to word things, but you know. But I'm working on not being allergic. If I get to the point where it just randomly snaps and I'm good, then like there we go. I mean, you know, Claritin and shit, that shit helps a lot, so it's pretty good. My grandma said you're cute. Tell your grandma to keep it in her pants. Okay. Are you a poser? I don't give a fuck. I'm not 13. I really don't give a shit. Anybody that gives a shit either is 13 or has the mindset of a 13-year-old in like a 30-plus-year-old body, which is also embarrassing. So, which is ironic coming from the guy that's dressed up as, you know, whatever the fuck I am, but nonetheless, I stand by my opinion. I didn't go to the Crow premiere. It was a showing. We were misled. By misled, I mean Carrington was misled. But Carrington wasn't really misled, he just didn't read it correctly. Therefore, I still had a good time. And I got free popcorn and soda. And I did enjoy the film pretty well. Did I love it? It was good. It was good. My mom loves you. That's very sweet of her. That's awesome. Does your mother make cookies? Can she just make me cookies? I'm just kidding. I actually don't want cookies. I literally do not want cookies at all. Do not give me cookies. But I do want candles. I'm into this idea that I could just collect candles and like scent stuff. I don't know why that's a thing at the moment, but it's in my brain. What are my Halloween costume plans? Oh, I've never planned in my life. I would like to serve on Halloween, though. Hallow's Eve. I haven't really thought of what I would be. I'll probably just throw it. I'll just kind of wing it. Wing it. That's how you say it. Going down the candle pipeline. Is that a thing? Shit. I'm going down a lot of pipelines right now. I'm in my pipeline era. I wish it'd be cool if I could light a cigarette right now, because then I could smoke a cigarette while streaming, while holding this cool big lighter and lighting the cigarette with the big lighter. And it'd be really cool. At least five people will talk about it. I have like 50 candles lit right now. That's too many, quite honestly. There's a good amount of candles, and I feel like 50 is pushing it. 50 candles is like old candle air. You wouldn't have any real air. You might die from the candles. Sweeney Todd is very hard to pull off. He has crazy hair, and I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to do it. Therefore, that's out of my wheelhouse. Millhouse. Shit. I'm going as Chapel Roan. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. No one else is going to do it, so I'm going to do it. I'm not doing it. It would be impressive, though. I don't know. I kind of will let last minute decisions pick that one for me. I mean, we got time. Thank you, one Maya. What is the Halloween? Thank you, Riley. What is the Halloween Horror Nights this year? What are the thingies going on? What are the horrors nights? God, you know what I like about Halloween Horror Nights? I like the drinks too. They have fun drinks, which makes me seem like I just drink a lot, and I don't. Only like probably 3 or 4 times a week, I would say. Probably more so 3. Maybe 4. Maybe 5. It depends on the week. Maybe 0 times some weeks if I'm feeling really crazy. Oh, I don't think they're all announced. They have Ghostbusters. I think they had that this one other year too. I guess this is based around the new film though. The newer film. I've not seen. A Quiet Place. That sounds... I've watched the first one, and I think I watched the second one. But I don't remember what... Is it like an alien or some shit? I don't remember what's going on there. Insidious. That looks like Freddy Krueger, dude. Leatherface. Your fresh meat. Okay, why'd I say it like that? Eternal Bloodlines. You know, I feel like, quite honestly, the ones that are not... even though I like properties, I feel like the property ones are not as good usually as the non-property ones. The Weeknd. Is The Weeknd like, I guess he's still like the man. He's like the famous guy. He's the famous guy. Was there like a new Insidious movie? Is that why we have this? Or am I misguided? I don't know if I've ever seen Insidious. No, I probably have. This looks familiar, but also I'm not sure if I've seen it. Maybe I need to watch it. What is this dude? What are you? He looks chill. I feel like he's misunderstood. I could fix you. I could fix him. Ah, this lady used to scare me. She used to scare me. She was scary. This movie looks scary. I don't know. No, I would not get a septum. It's not something I want. Is it bad my 6-year-old sister watched Terrifier? No, your 6-year-old sister should be watching Terrifier. Everyone that is, you know, like, I mean, I grew up on really bad movies that are much worse in a sense than Terrifier. Therefore, I believe that that is not a bad place to be at. And quite honestly, reality is very, reality is very reality. Reality is pretty intense. So therefore, Watching Terrifier is totally like chill. I mean, look at like all these kids are like on Twitter and shit. Like they're fucked. They're screwed. You know? The worst thing in their life cannot be watching a clown rip part of somebody for fun on a movie. It's just not that. It's really not that bad. I mean, hell, I remember like when I would go places and I would see like people get in car accidents and shit and like die and shit in real life as a child. So it's like, therefore, seeing a scary movie was never really necessarily the worst thing that you could probably see. You know, people got their other shit. Is it necessarily something that should be encouraged? Yeah. I wouldn't even say it shouldn't be. I think it's like chill. Thank you for the 200 bits, Leah. Leah, thank you very much. Smile. I didn't even like Smile 1 that much, but maybe I need to give it another chance. A lot of people thought it was pretty good. Maybe I'm just a freaking lame. Should I get back with my toxic ex? There's no way that's a genuine question, correct? Should I get back with my toxic ex? Reread that. Thoroughly enjoyed your driving video. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks, Rose. Smile's so boring. I wouldn't say that. I just thought it was fine. I didn't think it was like bad. There's no update. Why do people have to ask for a back tattoo update? There's no update. My body's in pain from other tattoos. I show you guys once I get things tattooed. It's not something I keep secret. Johnny, reveal your tattoo that you would have already shown us. There's no update. That's not how it works. It doesn't just randomly grow every few days and it's like, oh my God, here it is. It's grown now. It's more filled in. I have to go and get it filled in and it hurts. But I'm gonna do that September. Hereditary is good. How long is it going to take? I don't know. Whenever I probably two more sessions, one to two more. Whenever those are done. Muscle updates. They're muscling. Did you email YouTube about your video? They said no. There's nothing that can be done. Sometimes you do videos and they get considered not suitable for advertisers or not suitable for a younger audience. Therefore, you get L'd. If I'm lucky though. Ah, Yanni. That's my name. That's a sleepy me. Yanni. Ooh, I wish I could raise my arm higher. It just hurts so bad. Baby, I never wanna let you. The more I wanna let you know that everything you do. Does this mean you don't get paid? No, I get paid. For how I still get paid, it's just less, but I don't really care. Money's, I'm fine financially. I can have videos flop. I promise, but I mean, I love making money. It's very nice to make money, of course. It's a nice thing. But more so, the thing that sucks is when you put time into something that you want people to view and then it gets tanked. Well, I mean, you know, at the now. So yes. Do you like A24 films? Yes. I don't think it's gonna flop. It's flopping right now. I could see it's like a 8 out of 10 on my last 10 videos. It was a 7, which understandably it's not gonna do as well as like a here's Jake, Johnny, and Karen 10 video. Like I know that's always inevitable. But Yeah, I mean, it's kind of been like at a standstill since, you know, it got age restricted. But I still think it will probably get like 250,000 views pretty quickly. To which is really, you know, still good. It's unfortunate though. It's a really fun video. So I don't know. I've seen other people do the video, and their videos aren't age restricted or even limited ads. Oh, well, I don't know if they're limited ads, quite honestly. I can't really tell, but age restriction, I'd be able to tell. Nonetheless, life goes on, you know. You bitch about it for 2 seconds and you just gotta get on your toes. You gotta wobble around in the circle, and then you gotta exist. Shows your muscles. No. Why would I show you my muscles? The fuck? What do you think this is? Thank you, Aaliyah. I don't even know if I have muscles, quite honestly. So, I'm not really sure if it's something I should. He has none. I don't know what she loves up to. I don't know. I don't keep up with him. I do videos on him like month after he's made his video on me, and then I'm like, oh, he made a video on me. I didn't know that. I don't think he made anything. I think that was it. Yeah. They banned me. Yeah. Should I sneak out tonight and egg this girl's house with people? No, that is the most idiotic, immature, fucking stupid shit. Listen to what you just said. Even if you dislike this person, that's insane. You shouldn't be egging people's houses. Like, come on, what world are we living in? A mean guy, but I'm mean. Actually, I'm not mean. I'm telling you not to egg someone's house. Yeah, no. That's so dumb. Do you lose money from premium users? I don't know. Probably, I don't think so. I think you, I don't know. I don't really, I just do my shit. I don't really know. I don't analyze it super hard at this point. I just kind of do my best. My shit looks sore. My chest like literally hurts. It's so sore, dude. You can see how sore it is. It's like fucking pain. It just hurts. Anyways. Pasta. You're my emo awakening? Oh, thanks. I sneak out for pizza before. Oh, well, that's fine. No, I understand that, and I respect that. How are you feeling? I'm pretty good, I think. Why did you just flash us? Don't flatter yourself. That was not my intention. My intention was to show my tattoo that is in pain. If you got a little bit of a nip slip, then lucky you. But that was not my intention. If your chair was a celebrity, who? Wait. If your chair, what? What? If you was a chair, if I was a chair, what celebrity would I let sit on me? My chair? You don't need to know that. You don't need to know this. It would be who's that guy that plays Paul Blart? It'd be that guy. Kevin James. It'd be Kevin James and it would not be Kevin James. It'd be Kevin James and Steve Buscemi and Tommy Wiseau and none of these are completely accurate at all. None of these are accurate at all. Quite honestly, I don't think I would want any, I don't know if I would want I mean anyways, I don't want to be a chair. I think is the best way to put it. I don't want to be a chair. I thank you for the offer, but I don't want to do that. Thank you for the subs, Sophia. Thank you so much. What is your dream collab, musically or YouTube video wise? I don't really. I want to be on like something like Hot Ones, of course, but I gotta like obviously be clouded, and I don't got the clout for that. So I'm gonna have to do it myself. I don't see the thing is with like YouTube collabs, I don't necessarily want people in my videos or anything. I don't like the idea of organizing something and telling people, hey, this is what we're doing, and trying to be the guy that's doing it. I like to be in other people's stuff because then I don't have to think, you know, besides my existence. Would I collab with Trisha again? Yeah, I would totally. I would go on her show again for sure. I don't know if we would like collab, but I would go on her show. Careless Whisper cover. I've done that before. I'll do it again. I love that song. I want to do an actual studio cover of that someday. As the music dies, something in your eye. Words. Thank you for the 100 bits, Corbin. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet. Got no rhythm. I haven't played this song in a long time. It's one of the best songs in the world today. It's one of the best songs. Never meant. The careless whisper of a good friend to the heart of mine. Ignorance is kind. There's no comfort in the truth. Pain is all you'll. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. Waste the chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Music seems so loud. I wish that we could lose this crowd. Maybe it's better this way. We'd hurt each other with the things we wanna say. We could have lived, wait, we could have been so good together. We could have lived this dance forever. But now who's gonna dance with me? Never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. So it's easy to pretend. I know I'm not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. Waste the chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you. Oh. Song. To the heart of mine, ignorance is mine. Jimmy Dean Sausage. I don't know about that. Is Jake and Carrington watching? No, they're not home. I'm home, but they're not home. Come as you are, as I want her to be. Alright, I gotta send this to my sister. DMV. Ooh, someone's working on getting their license. It's me. I'm the guy. The guy is me. And it's not that I'm necessarily gonna utilize it, but the idea of just having it and saying, yes, I can drive. Should I after that last video? No, but should most people in LA? Probably not. I've got trouble thoughts soon. Man, my candle looks like a fudge brownie a little bit. And not in like the way of describing like somebody like an actual brownie, it looks like. And it kind of makes me like want to take a bite of it. Can recreate the video. Oh yeah, so what we're gonna do is I'm gonna get the license and then we're gonna recreate the video in real life. No, we're not gonna do that. We'll consider it. We'll flip a well that's not fair if I just say we're not gonna do that. My bad. We will do a spinning wheel, and if it lands on it, then I have to do it. My bad. Driving in LA sucks. Yeah. It's the worst, probably. It seems very anxiety ridden. It seems like, you know, the idea of driving in general, not too bad, but LA especially, or places that are big cities, can be very yes. Intense. Enya Montoya. Minutes is actually 1 hour. Whoa. I don't understand what you mean. Are you talking about for my stream? Should I eat my mom? I have a perverted mind and I don't like how that question sounds. Hope I die first. Thank you. No, you should not. Johnny, don't say that. What country are most of your viewers in? I don't know. I'm not fucking looking.
Where are you?
I don't want to know. I don't know. Counting Crows, Mr. Jones. I don't know how to do that song. Mr. Jones and me. Something. I only know how to play Accidentally in Love, and that's all I'm ever going to know how to play by them. Which is fine. Riley, thank you so much. I can't say handsome right now. What? You just said it. I like Old Bay. I don't know. Oh, Old Harambe? I'm lost. You have really pretty eyes. I get told that sometimes, and it feels nice sometimes. Thank you, I guess. No, thank you. Yes, thank you. I don't know. They're the only eyes I've got, so... it's hard to compete though, because Carrington has like very luscious eyes, so therefore my eyes are like usually down at least 3 points of the natural rating that they're usually put at. So is it really echoing? Is it Echo and the Bunny covering Amy Winehouse song? I haven't posted it, but I did the one where she Back to Black. But I didn't know if I wanted to do that one because there's a word that goes like kept his dick wet, and I'm just like not really sure if I want to say kept his dick wet. So what I said is kept her wet, which I don't know if I necessarily feel that much better about that either. It just feels really vulgar for me, but nonetheless, I think the cover was good, so maybe I'll make it like public, but. Or do it again or something, but I like the song a lot. It's a great song. I mean, a lot of people like it, but I just don't know if I want to talk about people being wet in a song necessarily. It just feels very vulgar, you know, but I'll probably do it because, you know, maybe they just showered or something, you know, that's possible. I'll do it. Dobby Vanity ass lyrics. All right, well, there's a very big difference. Hers, no. I will not allow that. No. Not at all. That's, I can see why you got that. But no. It's like the first lyrics.
No time to regret. Kept
autistic way with the same old safe bet. Me in my head high, in my tears dry. Get on without my guy. You went back to what you knew, so far removed from all that we went through. And I tread a troubled track, my odds are stacked. I'll go back to black.
Sounds sick though.
We only said goodbye with words. I'd die 100 times. You go back to her and I go back to us.
It's such a sick song. I don't care that I said that he kept his dick wet. You know, sometimes dicks are kept wet nonetheless. It's just a reality of it. It's a great song.
We only say goodbye words. I die 100 times.
I wonder if there's like a higher key that would sound like. Like, I wonder. Maybe like.
We only said goodbye with words. I die 100 times. You'll go back to her and I go back to my. We only said goodbye with words. I die 100 times. You go back to her and I.
Shit, I like it better the other key. It's probably more in the middle ground. I could do a guy version. Well, I did do the guy version of it on my thing that I've not posted, but the problem with that is, one, I don't really necessarily usually like to do that. I like to just play the songs how they are. But also I did that and I just removed the word dick, so it was just saying kept her wet, which is also very vulgar and makes me a little uncomfortable. Not that the idea of keeping, I mean, just in the sense of the lyrics, it's just like, gosh. But nonetheless, I like the song a lot. Amy Winehouse, W.
And I can't help but be in tears. Everyone close to me's not near. What can I do to repair this? Is there any purpose? Is it too late to say I'm sorry again? Is it too hard to say I'm sorry again? Did I come off too strong? You know I really need a friend. Again. I lost all sense of control. My body separated from my soul. And everyone thinks that I'm an asshole. I wish I didn't have to let you go. Is it too late to say I'm sorry again? Is it too hard to say I'm sorry again? Did I come off too strong? You know I really need a friend again. Mm-hmm.
Is it too late for me? My SpongeBob. Sorry, what? I'm normal. Oh, the weather outside is weather. Weather, weather, weather. Thank you, my wife, Brian. I think it's Brian. My wife is Brian Stars. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's still me that makes you sweat. My, you think about in bed. When the lights are dim, your hands are shaking. As you're sliding off, you just think of what you did. How I hope to God he was worth it. The lights are dim, your heart is racing. As your fingers touch your skin, a better way, harder touch, a better fight. Boy, you'll ever meet, sweetie, you had me. Girl, I was ill, look past the sweat. Better love deserving of exchanging body heat in the passenger seat. No, 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 you know you will always just be me. Let's get these teen hearts beating faster. So testosterone boys and harlequin girls. Dance to this beat and hold that lover close. Testosterone boys and harlequin girls. We dance to this beat and hold that lover close. I guess we just end on the G. So I guess we're back to us. So cameraman, swing the focus. In case I lost my train of thought, where was it that we last left off? Pick up, pick up. Oh, now I do recall. We're just getting to the part where the shock sets in and the stomach acid finds a new way to make you get sick. I hope you didn't expect to get all of this attention. Let's not be selfish. Did you really think I'd let you kill this chorus? Let's get these teen hearts beating faster. So testosterone boys and harlequin girls, we dance to this beat and hold our lover close. Testosterone boys and harlequin girls, we dance to this beat and hold our lover close.
This chord, sorry, one second.
Dance to this beat. Dance to this beat. Dance to this beat. Let's get these teen hearts beating faster. Let's get these teen hearts beating faster.
I feel like it should be better, like it would be higher.
Skin on the linoleum board. This is the center court. Tuning in the puppet bowl.
I was just bullshitting that, sorry. It's not so pleasant, Nate. It's not like adventure, no.
It's sure how I know, but weed.
This might be a hard one. Boomer music? Boomer time?
The anesthetic never said it, and I'm wondering when the apathy and urgency is that I thought of owning. Oh, wrong chord.
What is this? I'm trying to figure this. Interesting. So what's the difference? It's no difference. Cool.
How many special people change?
That's high. Is this the right chord? Or like a quick one? Okay.
How many special people change? How many lives are living strange? Where were you while we were getting high? Slowly walking down the hall, faster than a cannonball. Where were you while we were getting high? Someday you will find me caught beneath the landslide in a champagne supernova in the sky. Someday you will find me caught beneath the landslide in a champagne supernova. Champagne supernova in the sky.
Figuring it out. I haven't played in a long time.
Wake up at dawn and ask her why. A dream of dreams, she never dies. Wipe that tear away now from your eye. Slowly walking down the hall, faster than a cannonball. Where were you while we were getting high? Someday you will find.
Oh, and then changes to an A, sorry.
Find me.
It's so high, guys, I can't do it. I have to figure out. If I practice it, I could get it back. Practice makes perfect. What we see. I've got sunshine. I don't know how to play that song.
Sunshine on a cloudy day.
I've got a lovely inside my brain. I've got you and me. That's a family. What's going on? Let's see what we see. That song's fire.
Go again. I kinda wanna be more than friends. So take it easy on me. I'm afraid you're never satisfied. And here we go again. We sing like animals, we play pretend. You're just a cannibal, and I'm afraid I won't get out alive. No, I won't sleep tonight. Uh-oh, I want some more. Uh-oh, what are we waiting for?
That sounds fun. I don't know. Dude, I'm so warm now. I wish my chest didn't hurt from this fucking tattoo. It's just fucking pain, dude. It, like, literally just fucking...
Uh-oh, our butts and more. What are we waiting for? Took a bite of my heart, bum, bum. And you can drive all night looking for the answers in the pouring rain. You wanna find peace of mind.
We could find a reason.
Your tattoo looks a bit irritated. It is. I think it was just like, maybe pushed on a little too hard, honestly. And so it got, really sore. I think that's, probably what happened. Nonetheless, I'll pull through.
Come with me, my love.
I love that song. Love, love. Love, love, love. I love songs like in this genre. This fire, this style. It's just zombie chords. Thank you, love, baby. Freaking went there. I did all that.
Come with me, my love, to the sea of love. I want to tell you.
So slow. What if I did it faster? Oh, wait, it goes. It would be like a punk song. It would be like,
come with me, my love, to the sea of love.
I don't
know. I want to tell.
Thank you, Aaliyah. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. I declare a thumb war if it did. If it did.
You feel me somehow. You're the closest to heaven that I'll ever be, and I don't want to go home right now. And all I can taste is this moment, and all I can breathe is your life. Sooner or later, it's over. I just don't want to miss you tonight. And I don't want the world to see me, because I don't think that they'd understand. When everything's made to be, I just want you to know who I am. You can't fight the tears that ain't coming, or the moment of truth in your life. Everything feels like the movies.
Yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive. And I don't want the world to see me, because I don't think that they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want you to know who.
I'm so warm, bruh. I'm dying.
Oh my god.
I wish I could play music without getting fucking hella copyrighted all over my fucking live channel. I'm cussing a lot. I'm sorry. I'm a bad guy for that. I should do better. Can you us in one song of can us in one of you songs? Oh, you're asking, can I sing one of my songs? I kind of like not. I could. What's up, Blue? How are you doing? I call you Blue. Hi, Grace. Oh, wait, that's not Grace. I thought that was Grace. That's Blue Raccoon. Threw me off. You both have blue in your name. Oh my god, my fucking tattoo. Dude, this is like the most sore thing. You can see how sore it is. Do you see this? That's irritated as fuck. Help me. How do I fix it? Fireflies. That sounds really hard. I mean, okay. On the acoustic guitar, it's hard.
You can drive all night.
Yeah, it looks painful, right? Get lidocaine spray for it. What does that do? Let it breathe? What am I supposed to do? What does that mean? Stop touching it. Right. Night phone? I'm going to cover night phone. Yeah, it's really red. I know. It's the reddest tattoo I've ever had. My other ones are honestly kind of hurting too. Lidocaine isn't like... Lidocaine? Isn't... I don't know what that is. Is that for tattoos? Lidocaine. I bought like Aquaphor, I think it was, for it. Lidocaine, I see. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really honestly know. It's numbing stuff. I got muscle now, guys. Muscle, man. That's actually not that much. I'm fucking weak. I need to get yoked. My shoulders are getting bigger though, that's for sure. Don't use lidocaine. Okay. I don't like putting cream on it. It fucking makes me all sticky. I just don't want that. I will though. It's probably gonna get better soon.
And I don't want the world to see me.
It's gonna hurt so much to get tattoos here. I can't even lift my arm right now. It hurts so bad. Tattoos there. And then I'll eventually get filler. So close.
I don't want the world to see me.
Which is the worst, pain or stickiness? Oh, pain or stickiness. Well, it doesn't get rid of the pain. The pain's still there. I mean, it probably eventually gets rid of it. Just not instantly.
Da, 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 da.
Should I do the Phantom of the Opera? No, I'm just kidding.
And sleepy came to me. Burr, 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 burr. That voice which calls my name, and da da da. And though I dream of you, for now I find
It's a very hard song to do.
Inside my mind, seen once again with me, a strange duet. My power over you grows stronger yet. Which calls to me and speaks my name.
I need to see what this chord is, I forgot. Oh yeah.
And do I dream again? For now I find
the Wait, is it? Oh yeah, is it this one? Let me make sure. No, is it? Oh yeah, no, it is. Oh my god, that's so easy. Well, it's not really, but I want to restart it. It's this chord. I just didn't know. I'll try it again. Ooh.
In sleep he sang to me. In dreams he voice which calls to me and speaks my...
I'm lagging. Fuck, I'm trying to play the Phantom of the Opera. Cock. That sucks. People just spam lag. I already know. It says my internet's good right now. My voice doesn't go falsetto anymore. I don't know how to do it. I've lost it. Damn it, threw off my Phantom of the Opera. Okay, where is it? It's like
seen once again with me a strange duet, our power over. Stronger yet, and though you turn from me to glance behind.
What is this chord? I don't know.
The Phantom of the Opera
is it right? Is it? Do they want me to do this?
Is there?
Would it start there?
Is there?
How did I do this before? What chord was it? Maybe there's another chord. That's crazy. 11th. It's so hard. It gets so complicated because I fucking play a full step down, so I have to like figure out where certain things are. Probably there. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
out, so they love that chord. It's like, it's like, where is it? I don't know where they put in it. Oh my god, I'm so warm. I need to turn on the air.
When you see me in the spotlight. But when you see me in the spotlight, spotlight. I put it, put it, put it, put it, put it, put it, put it.
Okay. Let me turn on my air. It's too much cold.
I wish the songs from Little Shop of Horrors weren't so difficult to play.
Suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. No doubt.
You and me, I can see us dying, aren't we? You and me, used to be together every day.
I don't know the next word.
Every day together.
Oh, it's okay, I see.
You and me, we used to be together every day together. Oh, always. I really feel that I'm losing my best friend. I can't believe this could be the end. He looks as though you're letting go. And if it's real, and
I don't know. I'm trying to remember it from memory. It's tough.
Don't speak, I know just what you're saying. So please stop explaining.
I don't really have a playlist that I listen to actively right now. I just kind of go from some. Why do you play Full Step down? Because of Elliott Smith. And some of my songs are Full Step Down now. Like Angel of Death and like Angel of Destiny.
Don't fade away from me anymore. I need some peace.
And there's, I think Looks Could Kill probably is as well.
You look so beautiful, but you know it's so. I'll die before I live. With the final mentor you gave me, I saw you,
Ariel's
in the sky. Life is a waterfall. Dur, 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 dur.
Thank you, Leah.
Dur, 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 dur.
Sorry for the big yawn. I just am really good at getting sleepy and doing that. Because we are the ones about the bow. You can drive all night. God, I can't believe I haven't released music in so long. It's really embarrassing. It's so fucking annoying. I have so much ready. And I haven't dropped any of it. And it's just like really making me sad. You should do Andy Biersack music. I've done that when I was younger. Can't do it anymore. We know each other too well now at this point. So. Me watching the drama. Dude, there's no drama. The fuck?
Aerials in the sky.
Are you two still available? Currently, the figurine is still available with the pin. Have you done a video on Corey Feldman? I have not, but I've thought about it. I just like feel like I'm gonna see Corey Feldman, and then it would like, I'd be like another person I've been an asshole to, like, cause recently I went to an event and James Charles was there, and it was like really awkward, cause I'm like, fuck, I've like made so many jokes about you, which I don't regret the jokes, I stand by the jokes, they're great jokes, you know, but nonetheless, I'm not trying to like get punched by James Charles. I don't think James Charles would punch me, though. That would be awkward as fuck. It was okay. I mean, I don't know. I don't know how to feel about it. You know, it's like, it's inevitable. You do, we do the same type of career. So, but I know he's probably seen some of those silly videos we've made where we made some jokes. I'm sure of it. Got some new piercings. It hurts. Some piercings. Oh, I would love to go to a Corey Feldman concert. I would love to go to that Limp Bizkit Corey Feldman show. That shit would be so sick, but I haven't gone to it. He'll punch you with the BD blender. I don't think he'd get violent with me.
I love you, 1, 2, 3, shoopy-doo. I love you, 4.
Jake and Johnny compilations. I will do that, but I don't want to really do it today because I'm kind of tired and stuff. But in the future, I have that in my category of things I want to do.
I love you, 4. That's more than I can afford an act, 2. Someday that I'm gonna...
He was mad. Why are you praying for his downfall? What?
I love you 5 times more than any boy from before. All they really cared about was worth what you put.
Opinion on Ghost Town? I used to know Ghost Town a lot. I don't really have much. I mean, I know Kevin or somebody. I don't remember. I'm so young. They used to make fun of me a little bit when I was younger. But then they now that you know, then I like. Started doing the YouTube stuff, and then they started fucking with me. But then I was good friends with them for a minute. I mean, pretty good friends. And then Kevin got, you know, had like some drug issues and some issues with, I guess, talking to minors or doing something with minors. I don't know, something sketchy. And then therefore is not somebody that I want to be around anymore. So therefore... It's a common thing that's happened in my life with being a young 15-year-old guy going on tour with all these emo bands or emo YouTubers, etc. It's a common thing to or just being in the industry. It's people are get called out a lot. I've had people in my life. I would say probably at least 8 people that I've interacted with that have been called out for being creepy. At least.
It's fucking a shame. And that's just, that's from people I know, knew personally to some level. Y'all. Why is everyone talking to minors lately? I think the reality is that people were doing that in general forever. And I don't think it's something that's new. I think a lot of people like to paint it out that way. It's not true at all. I also think that it's everywhere as well. It's not just a industry celebrity status thing. It's a thing that happens in general with your day-to-day life, with teachers, with people that are just working traditional jobs all around, which is unfortunate. What else is... people have a level of mental illness, I would say, and that mental illness, I guess, leads to them being weird like that, which is not justifiable, but I do believe that's probably what's going on with a lot of them, which is very unfortunate that we live in a reality where that's how it is. It's fucking, I mean, you know, to try to paint it out as like it's something, yeah, I mean, Elvis also got called out for that stuff, you know, years, like the list goes on and on. It's more people than you would probably expect. That, and those are just people that we know exist, that, you know, because like obviously we're not going to know the guy from Walmart necessarily or whatever, because it's like we usually know the people that are going to have some level of status of fame, I guess. So, but yeah, I mean, I don't know. I just don't like when people try to paint it out like it's a new thing, or it's like something that, because it's just like, it's always, unfortunately, it's been a reality forever. I think that if anything, and it's still not where it needs to be, but I think the reality is that voices are more heard now, and at least people are most of the time, at least getting their voices out there. But I'm not saying that it necessarily gets the justice that it deserves or anything, because that's a different situation. But it, yeah, I mean, it's been happening forever. It's super unfortunate. I mean, look at like Chris Hansen's show's been around before like the internet was probably around, I would say, or when it was fairly new. So, yeah, it's interesting. I mean, it's not really interesting. I mean, it is interesting, but it's fucked up. It's like a fucked up interesting thing. I was gonna say it's interesting and it's like not interesting, but it is. I mean, that's why so many people watch people get busted for being creeps. Like, you know, like people like Vitaly makes it his whole career now. Chris Hansen was a person that made it his whole career, busting people that are perverts. Yeah. Depending on where you are, it gets brushed off. I don't even like necessarily just think that. I think in general that it's just person by person situation, and it that can happen anywhere. Unfortunately, people brush off that stuff. A lot of like tragic things that happen to humans with, you know, a lot of sexual assault stuff, etc., gets brushed off, unfortunately. And it's really sad because or people make exceptions constantly, and you know, that's just everyone like has their quote-unquote line almost to a degree, and that's just strange. It's just strange to see. Yeah, anyways though, it's always an interesting conversation though. But me being someone that was younger and just like being around people that were like, especially like, you know, like the Sam Pepper days and V1I and etc., people getting called out, Ghost Town, Joel Favier, Front Porch Step, even Brian Stars to a degree, Austin Jones, maybe even Onision, I would say. Shane Dawson probably was another one. There's so many people that I've had, like, that have been kind of around that have been, you know, have their, they're obviously different situations, but yeah, their levels of things. And it's just like, damn. Romeo Lacoste, that's another person too. Did my first tattoo. Did not really vibe with that guy. I felt like he was very, not a very nice guy. But yeah, it's a tough world. Michaela, thank you. How's my day? It was pretty chill. I'm just waiting for Thursday, and then I just got a busy week. I got some meetings. I got a meeting tomorrow. I got to go in person. I got
We're doing a thing, an event of some sort. Not really an event. We're doing a little, I guess we'd probably say I'm doing like a party. Not for me. I mean, there's just a party that's going to be happening and we do those. And with that being said, we have to get stuff for that tomorrow as well. But yeah. So I think that's my day tomorrow, I'm pretty sure. Let's see my schedule. I had a meeting today. I have a meeting tomorrow in person. Fun. Get an Uber. This life sounds exciting. It's pretty exciting. Shopping for items for stuff. Oh, and then the next day I have an event for a Twitch stream. On Thursday with a bunch of other streamers, probably about 50 of them, and it's a, I don't know if it's been announced, so I don't want to announce it, but it's a tournament of some sort with a bunch of streamers, and I will post about it on Thursday when I'm doing it, and I'm gonna win. So yeah. And then I think Friday, if everything goes to plan, my cover of Saturday Night will be out. I haven't really announced that, but I'm waiting on it. It hasn't been approved yet, so I'm not really sure. But ideally, that's when it's supposed to come out. And you're probably wondering why I'm just dropping it as a single right now. It's because I'm waiting on switching distributors. So I was just like, I'll just throw it on my old one. And I wanted to utilize this artwork that I had for a different song that I never used, because I thought it was cool looking at it, and I felt like it fit. So therefore, I decided to just drop this one as a single before the cover EP. And I'm also just itching to drop music so bad. I'm streaming Thursday. I'm not streaming on my channel. I could stream on my channel, but I don't want to. I'll be on somebody else's stream on Thursday with a bunch of people. And it's should be really fun. I'm very excited for it. My dream tattoo. I don't have a dream tattoo. I never really watched his Minecraft videos. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just getting my dream tattoo. I don't know. I'm getting them. I get whatever like tattoos I want, pretty much. I want to get a gargoyle and shit. Thank you, Michaela. Thank you, Riley. Thank you very much, Riley. Do you like Fall in Reverse or Motley Crue? I like both. Opinions on Ron Iraki. He's a human being with he's always, I don't know. It's a tricky situation. There's a lot of sides to him, but I'm not like super analyzing him personally. I just think he's an entertainer at this point. And from my experiences of meeting him, which was probably years ago, he was cool. And our interactions, he's always been cool to me. But yeah, it's sometimes I don't agree with everything he says, I think is a good way to put it. But that doesn't mean I don't enjoy his music or can't look, you know, enjoy things outside of that, I guess. I don't know. It's a complicated situation. It's a very complicated thing. Are you trying to get me canceled on Twitter? Because if I don't just say, fuck that guy, then the whole internet's going to be mad. Right? Isn't that how it works? Next tattoo. I don't know. Back tattoo. Yeah, I mean, it's like a human. Well, the reality is any human, you don't agree with everything on. That's just the reality. You don't agree with everything that I believe. That's just how it's going to be. I think it's really interesting that people have that mindset. But it's nonetheless something that just stirs up the whole internet pot, and then the internet gets mad. If you agree with everything, there's a problem, yeah. Do you still defend Dream? Okay, that was a fucking idiotic thing that I did, and I was very stupid. My thing was not necessarily, oh, I gotta defend Dream. My thing was, like, to be fair, his video, fucking, when I watched it, I took pretty much the bait. I was like, oh, this is, I watched it and I was like, oh, maybe this is like completely how it is. Like, you know, it's a fucking hour long video. It seemed really in depth. And I was like,
up late and I was seeing everyone going at him constantly. And I was just like, fuck, maybe this is like one of those cases where, and then, you know, moments after I was like, wait, I'm being a fucking idiot. Nonetheless, that's something that's always going to be held against me. And, I don't think my thing was necessarily, oh, I want to defend Dream. My thing was more so what I posted was you should watch his video and hear his side. And, no, I don't even care, nor do I care to be involved with that situation. That was stupid of me. I never really knew much about the guy. You're also allowed to change your mind. Oh yeah, I know. But the reality is that the internet will not allow that. The internet does not allow that because the internet is a bunch of prude fucking assholes who like to hold everyone above themselves. And it's fucking arrogant fucking douchebaggery. So therefore, if I were to be like, hey, I don't even want to be involved in this situation. I wasn't educated enough and what I said is wrong and I should have never said that. That's not enough for anybody. And it will still always be on my record of, oh, Johnny's a fucking idiot. Johnny's a disgusting piece of shit. Da 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 da. That's just how it constantly goes. And I don't think that's right. I think that's very ridiculous and harmful to humans existing. People need to be able to fucking constantly grow. And people need to constantly be educated. And people need to constantly be able to own when they feel like they did something that they don't approve of. Oh, well, you're just doing it because of the backlash or whatever. That's always an argument as well. It's like, quite honestly, though, isn't that the point of backlash as well? So people will actually educate themselves to do better and to be more better, you know? You know, it's just idiotic. So, yeah. Defended AVA. Who the fuck's that? I don't even know who that is. I don't even know who that is. Ava. I have no idea who that is. Nonetheless, my video was, or my post was not, I know everything and this guy's innocent. My post was, I watched his video and I thought it was good and I thought it, people should hear his side. And then, you know, obviously things kept on developing and I realized why, like, the fuck. And then I also heard stories from people that, you know, I got to know in life that had experiences with people. And I just don't really, I was like, oh, maybe I am wrong on this. Maybe that was stupid of me. So, oh, Ava. People are saying oh my God, that is fucking idiotic. No. Well, also people think I'm a fucking transphobic person because I said like the T word once. Because I was telling people not to say the T word. That's another great example. Because I'm so transphobic because I have so many people in my life that are transgender and it's just fucking idiotic. Oh, but it's just idiotic. It's just dumb. There's no winning. No. The Ava shit was me saying a situation and then also it's like the Shane Dawson thing with Shane Dawson having a kid. I was saying people were being really homophobic towards him having a kid and him and his husband, and I pointed out that that's not okay. But obviously I said I understand why people are concerned with Shane Dawson as the individual having a child because of his history. Therefore, that's valid, of course. But people like to point it out as like, oh, you're defending this guy. And it's like, that's not the reality of it. This was me. Yeah. That's just people twisting shit. I'm sorry that I like want to be supportive of people loving who they love and living the life that they live and being in the body that they feel comfortable being in and being the person that they are. And maybe I don't do every single thing perfect. And I know that. But that's something that I've always stand with. When it comes to individuals that have had issues for making gross jokes or et cetera, I hold them to the same accountability as any other individual. I don't put their who they're into or how they identify in that realm. And that's my whole point of either of those situations is that should not be even in the discussion. The only reason why it's in the discussion is because people try to use it as a narrative to be anti-LGBTQ+. So
Yeah. It's just can't win. You can't win. I don't know my opinion on, like, I don't know Marilyn Manson. Like, I assume he's probably not a great guy. I'm gonna be honest. I assume he's not probably a great guy. Speak your mind even if your voice shakes. Is my voice shaking? I don't think so. Marilyn Manson, I don't know. I probably not a great guy, but when it comes to the art that he's made, I do think that I do enjoy that art. Do I still like indulge in it? No. But was there a time where I was into his music and his paintings, etc.? Yeah. I just don't even know enough about the situation, honestly. It's also a lot to expect people to like have the time or to have the energy to emotionally deep dive into all these situations when there's so many. Like, let's be real. It's like, you want me to deep dive into like 12 people's fucking intense fucking documents, and even if I watch like a YouTube video on it, it's still like a 5-hour series at least on one individual. It's like so fucking difficult to, and then you still don't get a black and white answer on it. You get a, it's a very difficult thing. And I'm just saying this as a person that's a human being. So, yeah. I don't know Elphiba. I have seen that person. I don't know anything about them. Yeah. No offense. I've met No Offense. I don't know much about Noah. I know Noah just played the Blood Festival. Bloodfest. Two sides to the story. Honestly, you get more sides than that. There's a lot of sides to stories because telephones and etc. And it's not, I mean, it's just, I don't know. Every human, I think, usually is trying their best. At least that's how my mind works. I couldn't imagine living a life where you're not trying your best. And that's kind of, I guess that's what makes, some people are, I just don't actually think like that. So maybe I'm actually wrong. Some people are mentally not there to that level to where they try their best to be a understanding or a kind person or, you know, not horrible, and then therefore it makes the world a little more complicated. Keeps it interesting, I guess. not good though. Queso seems cool. Brooke, I don't have thoughts on Brooke's situation. I am like not the person to get involved in that. That is a situation with race, and I am just a white dude, and nor do I really watch Brooke or know her or anything. I've never met her, but so I just feel like the last thing we need is me to give my opinion. Also, I just, she can give her own opinion on it, and her, you know, people that are close to her. It's just not really a situation. It's not like one of those situations where it's like, oh, is this person a creep or something? The Brooke situation is her saying some very offensive racist tweets. Some were about Trayvon Martin, I think his name was. Is that his name? I'm sorry if I don't know. Trayvon? I think so. Yeah. So I don't know. I honestly haven't really fully looked into that situation more than that, but that's what I know. It's just not my place. I don't really want to give an opinion on anything. I don't want to get involved in that more than that. Like, it's just, faking disabilities. I mean, that sounds not good to do. I don't know what to tell you. Like, people want like a clear answer on something that's already like clear in their mind. Hey, this person is faking disabilities. What are your thoughts on that? That's bad. What? Hey, this person said some racist things before. What are your thoughts on that? Bad. where do I go from that? Like, the fuck? I don't know what I'm supposed to say. Like, bad things are bad. In general, I just hope people fucking do, you know,
keep on improving, even if people don't, like, you know, want them in their life anymore, et cetera, or even want to accept it, et cetera. But bad things are bad, and I hope people just continue to try to do better. I think that's a valid and fair thing to think in general for all these statements. Bad things bad, please do better. Start doing deep dive videos on reaction videos. I just don't, I like to do them on the live channel because it's more like laid back. I don't like doing the like super deep divey, like trying to go for someone thing. It's not my, I just don't, I'm not that guy. I try to be that guy, and I did it well, but I'm just not that guy. It's not really something for me. It's, I care about like, well, one, I care about like a lot what people will say about me as well, because people will, like, you know, agree with my opinions, and then my opinions will be going back and forth. But, and that makes me feel bad or whatever, because I can't please everyone with that stuff, and it's very serious topics. Where, and I also, like, you know, I can be very generous, I guess, because I know personally I've done a lot of things that I regret, like, as you know, saying stuff and etc. Like, and I probably still do occasionally do shit that I don't approve of later on, or I fucking feel like, oh, what I, like, you know, etc. So sometimes my mind gets a little too compassionate towards people that maybe need a little bit more of a boot on their butt. But also, with that being said, sometimes I feel like people only want to be negative too, though, with those situations. So I just don't want to be in that game too much. The nonstop drama is mentally draining for sure. It's maybe some people can handle it. I don't know. Important part is regret and understand. Yeah, I mean, logically, that's correct. Not, it doesn't, it, people still, as I said, people hold things against people forever. And obviously, everyone's got their own lines. So, but yeah, logically, I agree that, I mean, what else could you expect from a person? And the problem is that people are always like, it's disingenuous, and it's very unfortunate. And I understand the questioning of people's genuine authenticness and everything, because some people aren't. But there's really nothing else you can do besides try to, in my mind at least, give people the benefit of the doubt that they're going to try to do better. And if they don't try to do better, then I guess that really says a lot. But ideally, I just want people to do better. I don't know. Do I F with Ethan Klein? I mean, I watch H3 sometimes. Not like super often. I don't really. I mean, Ethan sometimes says some silly stuff for sure that I don't agree with. But I mostly just watch his like drama stuff and his like the whole crew. I like the whole like H3 podcast like crew, like Olivia and like Sam and all them, and Dan and Zach and Love and whoever else is there. But I don't watch all the time. I go in and out with it. I don't really watch too much YouTube. I mean, I kind of do, but not really. I used to watch only YouTube. Now I don't really. It's not the same. YouTube's not the same. You know? It's really not the same. People only want to hear about like really bad things happening in the world, or things that are happening with individuals that have done something that you want to scrutinize them for, or, you know, some crazy release of some sort. And if you don't have either any of those, then it's like people aren't really listening at the moment. I'm not wearing a vest as a tank top. You watch your own videos sometimes. I try to. I like my videos for the most part. But, you know, YouTube, it's like, it's very similar to like something like VidCon or something. It's just become a different like thing than it used to be. Like VidCon used to be just like content creators existing and people would come up to them and they would just all kick it. Now it's very like you do your panels. That's how it goes. And YouTube as content creators has become either, I don't know, like, yeah, just a lot of interesting stuff. I'm not really sure. TV show to watch. I don't know. I have not idea. Got a little pimple there, bro. Dude, my tattoo hurts so bad. Fuck. It's hard to fall asleep right now. It's like so dry, dude. I don't know what to do. Ugh. This one's dry too. Yeah, people do only care about drama, and I know that because I'm one of the people that indulges into a lot of drama. So, I'm a part of the problem. That's how I did my studies on it, is, do you do it? Yes. Okay, there you go. What are you more likely to click? Entertaining. Yeah, for sure. All right, well, I'm probably gonna get off. Let me braid somebody. My tattoo is like hurting really bad, so I don't really want to be on stream any longer. Thank you for that deep talk. I hope I didn't offend anyone, but you know, what can you do? You've grown up so grown up. Now I must see more than ever. Alright, I'm gonna raid Frogan. Alright, thank you all. Check out my new video, please. And I appreciate you all so much. Hugs and kisses. XOXO. Bye. Bye, everyone.